Okay, good morning everyone. I'm Kelly Renee, you're on Sharing Our Shine, and today's a show and tell video with six kits, three of which are off canvas and three that are on canvas. And I'm going to go ahead and get started with these three that you see here. Thanks for joining me, I really appreciate it. And I do apologize, I haven't been as productive as I am with my videos. I'm just getting over the flu, I'm on the other side of it. I still have a little bit of a cough left, but it's pretty much under control. So, the three items I have here, one is a mirror. And I bought this from Temu. You can get diamond painting mirrors, and if you open it up, I've shown this in one of my haul videos. And I kept, it flew away. But I kept a piece of parchment paper inside here just to keep the fingerprints off of it. But I'll be gifting this to a friend shortly, but that's what that looks like. And hopefully you can see that well. Let me see if I can get the light to better represent. There we go. So that's a diamond painting mirror, compact mirror. Then I have these two items here. And these are passport covers that I completed. And they took about, I don't know, 3-4 hours maybe to fully complete them. They're different, as you can see. And I will be giving one of these away in the future as well. This one, as you can see here, I've got a little bit of an item sitting here. And this is nothing more than washi tape that I used as a ribbon. I didn't have any ribbon handy, and I really wanted a piece of ribbon. So I just used some washi tape back to back and made myself a ribbon. And then I added two magnets for a closure, to make myself a little notebook. Normally these, what you put your passport in it and you have a nice cover for it, which was my original intention. But then I saw these on Amazon, and these are supposed to be passport size notebooks. And I said, well, I'm gonna get these and put them inside here and make a notebook out of it. And that worked out well, with one exception. Either these are too small for a passport or these are too large for a notebook. One that I ended up doing was I took out the staples here and I had to cut down the notebook. If you just cut like this one border off here and leave this full border on the other side, or cut down half of this and half of this, it'll fit inside, and then I restapled it. And that's what you see in here. And I didn't do a very good job. This is just for a family member. As you can see, this is cut down. Here's the original. And as you can see the difference in the margins at the very top, I had to cut in at the very bottom. I had to cut this down and restaple it in order to fit it inside the passport cover. But I liked it so much that I decided to keep it. And again, I took two magnets that we would normally use on cover minders, and I made a closure for it. And that seems to be working well. And I have several of these. So, and I really did enjoy making these with the special drills and everything. But those are the two finishes that I have for the passport covers. Okay? And again, these were purchased on Temu. They're also available on Amazon for a higher price. And these I did get on Amazon. I can't recall. I got a package of 12. 12 of these, to go with all of the passport covers. But I think they'll make a really nice gift when you put your closures on there, and it'll just stay closed for you. You may have to do, I did have to shave a little bit off the end as well to get the magnets to fit. I didn't have smaller ones at the time, so I just used what I had. But those are two notebooks you can make for giveaways. I think they make really nice gifts. Okay, so those are, let me put those back up here. Those are the three off-canvas items that I had to share with you. So, now some of these other canvas items you have seen in various stages. But here is my bee. My stained glass bee in a circle that I've shared. Now, I did bring this up with some ABs here and there. And the canvas allowed for a, I think it was 3865, to go around the border. I chose not to do that. Instead, I mixed paint and sand and did a stucco effect. Here, I didn't pull it very tight, so I have some wrinkling here, but this is just for myself. And then I used some double-sided tape and some glitter to give myself a little bit of a glittery border. Again, this is all based on your own taste. But this is the bee all finished and framed. And hopefully, I didn't want to get that glare in there. You can all see that, but it's fully done. And again, I'm going to bring up that technique a little closer to the camera so that you can see how it turned out. Again, that is a natural colored sand and some beige paint mixed together to make a stucco effect because I did not want to do 3865 all around the frame. I wanted to do something different. And that's what I did, and that's how it turned out. Very, very happy with it. Obviously, it's framed and it's ready to be hung up. So really, really happy with that. Okay. This isn't going to be a very long video, guys. I just have these six things. Now, this you've already seen, but you haven't seen it framed. This is the drinking horse that I did. And this is where I used that those granules, those stone granules, instead of drills in this area here. And I did a used glitter technique to do the pond. So you've seen this in some previous videos, but now I have it framed. And that is the final result. And again, I'm quite happy with how that turned out. And that is a gift, and that will be going to the giftee soon. Sorry for that. Can't seem to get that ring light to work with me. So it's kind of stuck there, but there you go. And the last one. Now, those first two were in wood frames, traditional frames. This one I did on a artist stretch canvas. This is Harley Quinn. She's a clown. That is a gift for next month for my niece. Again, I painted the stretch canvas black. I mounted the diamond painting on the canvas with double stick tape. I did do a black on black flat pearl on the corners as a technique. I also used some strips of dazzle that I happen to have. I have lots and lots of dazzle. And I also did a 3D technique on this canvas. Hopefully you're seeing that well. That's here and here. I actually wove ribbon through the canvas to make a little 3D effect right next to these flowers. And I do have a little bit of ribbon kind of undulated. Hopefully you're seeing that right here with some little butterflies. Oh, I may have to glue that. No, do I want to glue that? No, I'm going to leave it. Some little butterfly accents here and up. In the bows, I also added some butterflies here. And that just adds a little bit of a 3D effect. I also added a charm here and a chain. Just to give it a little bit more bling, a little bit more of a panache. I'm not really super crazy about the way that chain. It looks like she has no neck. And I've tried it a few different ways and I settled on this. So I'm going to live with it. But I do have this canvas. I did buy this canvas again because I really didn't like it. So I may try the chain a little bit differently on the next one. But you can see on all four corners here, black on black pearl, flat back pearls on each corner. And if I tip it, I'm going to see if you can see that. Black on black stenciling. And I did not gloss the outside because I really wanted it to be matte. And I'm hoping that you can see it if I tip it. It's very, very subtle. But I did use the same black paint that I painted with to put a little bit of a design along this edge. And again, because it's black on black, you almost have to see it in just the right light. But it leaves it gives it a little bit of a design without it being too in your face. So I did that technique. So if you haven't tried that, give that a try. Let me see if you can see it better down here. Maybe you can see it better. Just down there, just use the stencil and the same black paint just to give it a little bit of imagery. And on the eyes, if you can see that, up here, I did use a dimensional glaze just in her eyes so they stood out a little bit more glossy than the rest of the diamond painting. I'm hoping you can see that. Let's see here. It's hard to bring it up, but if you can just see that her eyes are a little bit more glossy. And that's just so that it stands out. Now with the ribbon, again, I had to cut the canvas and I wove it through a couple of times to give it the dimension I wanted. And then I used alcohol ink to dye it the colors. Alcohol ink and a Q-tip, I believe is what I did. I picked some of the colors that were up here and I dyed the ribbon just with the Q-tip and the alcohol ink. Again, just to give it a little bit of a something something. It doesn't have to be just so flat. Okay? And I took that same dazzle stripping, very thin, and it's right here. It's not perfect, guys. This is handmade. And I just stuck it around the edges here, along all four edges, just to kind of frame it out a little bit and let it stand out a little bit more. So that is the finished She's a Clown canvas that I made for my niece for her birthday next month. So I have that one. Do a summary. The drinking horse all framed and ready to go. I have the stained glass bee with the stucco finish around the edge. It's all finished and sealed, and I did bling it up here and there with some ABs that I purchased separately. I'm really happy with that. That's for me. That's a keeper for me. And then I have, again, these three off-canvas finishes. The mirror and the two passport covers that I did with special drills. And then I made them into notebooks by adding a magnetic closure and these little notebooks that you can get from Amazon, sticking them in the middle, and I'll be able to finish up a few more of these and give them away as gifts. So that's what I have for you for show and tell on this video. Let me know what you think in the comments. Really appreciate it. And for all my new subscribers, welcome, welcome, welcome. And I really need to get back on my 500 subscriber giveaway. As the channel continues to grow, I'm getting further and further behind. So I will do that very shortly. As soon as I can, I'm going to get to that. And we'll talk about what the giveaway is going to be at that time. I've mentioned it in previous videos, but if you haven't seen it, you may not know. So that's coming. So that's all I have for today. Thanks so much. As you guys go forth in your everyday lives, remember to share your shine with others and allow their shine to be reflective upon you, practicing tolerance and respect along the way. Thanks again, everyone. Let me know what you think in the comments. What's your favorite? What you liked? What you didn't like? Ooh, not crazy about hearing that one, but I'm willing to read the comments. Let me know what you think about all of these and the techniques that I used. This one with the stone granules and the glitter for the pond. This one I did the stucco border with the paint in the sand as opposed to the drills. And this one I did the 3D ribbon effect. I put it on a painter's stretch canvas. And I also added a chain and a charm, and I did the black flat black pearls along the edges here. And the black on black or color on color stenciling along the border. So I did different techniques with the different items and made them my own and would love to know what you think. Let me know in the comments again, guys. Thanks so much. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.